Hi beautiful people, it's Thatsqueenc. If you're new, welcome, and if you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. As you saw by the title of the thumbnail, I'm going to show you guys how I achieve some gorgeous heatless wand curls and how I install my 4x4 closure wig. So this is what the hair is looking like. This is 26 inches long hair, and I think it was Peruvian straight hair. This is what the hair is looking like after I have washed the hair a day before. So the first thing that I did is separating the first row, and then I'm going to apply my LottaBody foaming mousse. I'm going to use my Tangle Teezer to brush out the hair, and then I'm going to separate this bottom section into two equal pieces. When the hair has enough of the foaming mousse, I will go in once again with my Tangle Teezer to detangle the hair one more time to make sure that there are no knots in this hair. And then I'm going to use my flexirod. This is the biggest flexirod that I could find. This is the pink one, and you will see that the first two flexirods didn't go as nicely as all the others did, because I haven't done flexirods in months, maybe even years, I don't remember. But you will see that from the third flexirod everything is going so well. So at the end of doing all the flexirods, I did the first two flexirods over again. And that's actually all that I did. I just applied a little bit of the foaming mousse. I detangled the hair with my Tangle Teezer. And then I added my flexirods. And I think I used 8 or 9 flexirods in total. So you can see that I'm using very big chunks of hair. These are not small sections at all. I think it took me 15 minutes in total to apply all the flexirods. So this is a very quick and easy style. And something that I want to mention real quick about this hair is that I cannot give you guys some more details or information about this hair, because I have this hair for years, like literally years. The only thing that I can remember is that these bundles were 26 inches, and I think it was Peruvian straight hair. But I really don't remember where I ordered this hair from. I only know that I ordered these bundles and that I made it into a wig all by myself with a 4x4 closure, which was matching the bundles perfectly. So that is all the information that I have. Of course, you can buy your Peruvian straight hair somewhere else and achieve the same look. So this is what the hair was looking like after I was done adding all the flexi rods, and I did put my wig under the hooded dryer because I was in a big rush and still wanted to wear my wig out. And I would definitely recommend to style your wig one day before you will actually wear it, just so the wig has the time to dry completely. But I was in such a rush that I had to put my wig under the hooded dryer for about an hour, and it still wasn't completely dry. And yep, that's me. This is what my hair is looking like. It was looking like a hot mess, but who cares if you're going to wear a wig. So I'm going to apply my Cream of Nature Coconut Milk Edge Control. This is one of my favorite edge controls to use on my edges. So I'm going to spread that all over my edges, and I'm going to brush my hair to the back with my edge brush. As you can see, I'm just smoothing my edges out. I'm not doing any swoops or baby hair or cute design. I'm just brushing all my hair to the back because I don't want my type 4 hair peeking out in front of this wig. And when I'm satisfied, I'm taking my dark brown wig cap. I think this wig cap matches my skin perfectly when I'm wearing my wig. So this is the one that I like to wear. I have like a lot of these wig caps. I really, really love them because they're also very tight. So that is what I do, and now I will show you guys the wig once again. This is what it was looking like after being under the hooded dryer for about an hour. I will put it on my head and see how the wig is fitting my face. So it's time to take out the flexirods, and you will see that I'm feeling if my hair was dry, but it was still damp at this point. As I said before, I was in a big rush, but I still wanted to film this for you guys, so that's the reason why my hair wasn't completely dry. Yeah, I could definitely done better with this video, but as I said, I was in a rush and still wanted to film this for you guys, so that's what I did. But you will see me fixing that a little bit later on in the video. So after I decided how I'm going to wear my wig, I'm going to take the lace a little bit to the back, and I'm going to apply the Got to Be freezing spray exactly where I'm going to lay down my lace. So that is what I did. I blow dried the first layer until it was dry, and I applied a total of 3 layers. And when the third layer was still a little bit sticky, I'm going to attach my lace closure exactly on the sticky part of the Got to Be freezing spray. And I'm going to lightly press this down with my Rattail comb and my fingers. I don't know if I've said this before, but I'm really not that good in doing my baby hairs, not with my natural hair, but also not on wigs. So I'm doing my best, but these baby hairs are not looking like anything at all. But I did my best. I applied a little bit of the LottaBody foaming mousse and also a little bit of the Got to Be freezing spray to set my edges and to give them a little bit of shape. When I'm satisfied with how everything is looking, I'm going to take my elastic band and tie this around my head to make my lace completely melt down into my skin. As you can see, I was feeling if my hair was still wet, and yes, it was still a little bit damp. So I will take my blow dryer and blow dry my hair a little bit for like, I think I only blow dried my hair for 5 minutes because, as I said many times before, I was in a rush. And you know, when your hair is still a little bit wet or damp, your curls won't pop as much as they will do when your hair is completely dry. But yeah, I still had to go out, so I took my wide tooth comb and I used my fingers to spread down the curls. Even though I was combing out these curls, it still wasn't looking as nice as it could be. But you will see that when I took my Tangle Teezer, the brush, that these curls were getting so big, so soft and wavy. Like, oh my god, look at this. As soon as I used my Tangle Teezer, the waves were so big and soft and bouncy. So that is what I really, really loved about this hair. And once again, I still think that I could do much better. If this hair was completely dry, the curls would have been bigger, better, and nicer. And then the next step for me is to going in with my hot comb, and I put it on the second setting, and I'm using my Keracare wax stick to lay down the front of my wig. I need you to listen. I need you to listen. Ooh. You will see that when I take off this elastic band that there is a little bit of a white residue in front of my head. This is because of the foaming mousse and the got to be freezing spray, but I will take a little bit of this alcohol to wipe away this white residue. This is also the same alcohol that I use in the beginning before I added like the edge control on my edges and applying my wig cap just to clean down my scalp. But I did forget to show you guys how I did this. So that is actually it. I just try to feel if my wig is on the right place. I will touch up my baby hairs a little bit and then I will comb through the waves. And yeah, this is the finished look. And as I said before, I could definitely done better. The tip for today is definitely to let your curls completely dry before you take out any curling style that you're doing. But as I said many times before, I was in a big rush and I still wanted to go out. So this is what I ended up with. As you can see, I had some flyaways and I will just take my Karakare wax stick to lay this a little bit down and go over this with my hot comb. So I still actually loved how my hair came out, even though I knew I could have done better. But I still loved how my hair was looking at this point. So yeah, this is it for the video for today. So if you have any tips, any tricks, any good stuff to tell me, let me know in the comment section down below. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share, comment, subscribe and do all those things, because I want you guys to be a part of my family. And I'll hope to see you guys next week in my next video. Bye guys.